So why are we concerned with human exposure to endocrine disruptors and effects on health? We know that there's literally tens of thousands of chemicals in commerce. Numbers thrown around include approximately 80,000. Most of these chemicals have not been tested for effects on human health. Very few of them have been very well studied, and even fewer have been studied in relation to effects on the endocrine system. These chemicals to which we're exposed, there's literally many hundreds that are present in our everyday products, which leads to widespread, ubiquitous, general population exposure. So some of these endocrine disrupting chemicals are found in our cosmetics, our personal care products. They're found or they're used in food packaging and processing materials, building products. They're also used in medications as well as medical devices. So what this means is that there's very widespread general population exposure to literally hundreds of chemicals that may have endocrine disrupting properties. And the widespread general population exposure is to adult men, women, pregnant women, and children. So really all segments of the population are exposed to endocrine disruptors. As I mentioned in the beginning, they can cause a variety of health effects. Today we're focusing on reproductive effects, but they can affect the immune system, metabolism, development, et cetera. And then I'll just close with one of the final points, is that even though there is general population exposure to these chemicals, our exposure is at very low levels. But there is data suggesting that low-dose exposure to some of these chemicals can have effects in humans, and we'll be talking, I think, more about this as the forum progresses.